I'm Hunter Faddis, I'm an interior designer.
I'm Abbey Pitzer, and I'm a graphic design major.
I'm Sadie Thompson, I'm a health science major.
I'm Sam Russo, and I'm a textile design major.
And we've been traveling on the 2017 Nexus Abroad program at Thomas Jefferson University.
Over the past 3 weeks, we had the opportunity to study in Vienna, Berlin, Barcelona, and Prague. We've been learning all about how technology has shaped the cultures and movements here.
Enjoy our video!
Technology played a vital transformative role in Europe during the 20th century. Technological advances and propaganda during World War I, World War II, and the Communist era influenced the way people relate to each other, change their understanding of their identities and roles in society, and change the way people express their beliefs and opinions throughout art and design in order to deal with such traumatic experiences.
Before World War I, technology was very minimal. Since countries were competing against each other, they had to make technological and industrial advances for survival. In warfare, this is where we get the inventions and advancements of military weaponry and tactics, some of which include machine guns, airplanes, chemical bombs, and submarines. In addition to warfare tactics, the onset of the radio changed the way that individuals interpret the news. Instead of reading the news, a person could now hear it. Additionally, the radio made news get to people faster because there was no need to wait on publication.
During World War I, technology reflected a trend toward industrialism and the application of mass production methods in weapons and warfare. World War I was the first war in which mass media and propaganda played a significant role in keeping the people at home informed about what was occurring on the battlefields in real time. The onset of photography revolutionized the way that art was interpreted and created. For example, photos displayed real-time images of warfare, pop culture, and everyday life without an artist's interpretation. Photographs were plastered on newspapers, posters, and advertisements, shaping the way that warfare was perceived.
World War I changed the way artists understood the function of art. Many individuals rejected traditional forms because they believed that those forms can't possibly represent people's life experiences after World War I. For much of Europe, the destruction and lessons from World War I led to the rebuilding and rebranding of many political situations. During then, Hitler's ideas were circulating to form the Nazi Party. Many people often wonder just how the Nazi Party became so powerful and why they were able to carry out what they did. Through film, the Nazi Party was able to express German national identity and to create feelings of belonging among the German people. The propaganda used by the German Nazi Party in the years leading up to and during Adolf Hitler's leadership of Germany was a crucial instrument for acquiring and maintaining power and for execution of the Nazi policies by the use of propaganda through radio, photography, and videos to show the world that Germany was coming back.
Technology played a significant role in World War II. Many types of technology were customized for military use, and major developments occurred across several fields, including weaponry, logistical support, medicine, rocketry, communications, and intelligence. Hitler was a master of propaganda. He used media and rhetoric to his advantage by convincing the people that the Jewish and Gypsy community, as well as homosexuals, physically and mentally disabled, and anyone who did not look Aryan, were inhumane and had tainted bloodlines. He controlled the people with censorship, terror, and power. In our trip to Terezin concentration camp in the Czech Republic, we learned about the forms of media and technology that the Nazi Party used in order to paint the picture that Terezin was almost like a haven for Jews, homosexuals, and non-Aryans. They used prisoners at the camp who were artists to create posters and paintings showing Terezin as a safe and happy place.
Right? The propaganda was saying, you know, that the Jews are a different race and so on, so on, so on, so on, right? And of course people were had infections here, right? You know, the Nazi were not going through the ghetto. They were telling the Jews, and that was horrible, what to do with other Jews, right? And they were trying to save as much as possible.
atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Japan surrendered and led to the end of the war. In return, this led to the Nazi Party receding back to Germany, which led to the advance of Allied forces, which led to the end of the war. The development of atomic bomb was a huge breakthrough in technological advancements and also ended World War II.
Dum-dum, deedle-dum-dum, deedle-dum-dum, deedle-dum-dum. There was a turtle by the name of Bert, and Bert the turtle was very alert. When danger threatened him, he never got hurt. He knew just what to do. He'd duck and cover, duck and cover.
It asserted the United States as a superpower. It made the world realize how destructive and powerful having nuclear weapons are. In response, the Soviet Union began to research and test their own nuclear warheads to gain such power as the United States. This led to the arms race between the Soviet Union and the United States.
During the communist era in Eastern Europe, the Soviet government standardized and censored nearly everything. For example, the Soviet government implemented mass destruction of pre-revolutionary and foreign books and journals from libraries. In our trip to Libri Prohibiti, a library in Prague that houses exiled books from this time period, we saw ways in which individuals reacted to the censorship of books. Many people found innovative ways to create books like typing on tracing paper, bounding books with map board, or printing type on photography paper. Essentially, the censorship of art and ideas pushed people underground and influenced them to create private works and express the times that they were living.
According to Burns, during the normalization purges of 1969 to 70, dozens of magazines and journals were shut down.
In Berlin, the underground art scene was booming and led to the destruction of the Berlin Wall. Street art was a way for individuals to express their anxieties and frustrations with their political situation. We saw this when we visited the Berlin Wall East Side Gallery.
According to Kabrash, he considered the graffiti mecca of the urban art world Berlin as having a strong culture when it comes to visual street art, with the East Side Gallery being one of the best examples to illustrate how graffiti can be interpreted as a striking form of protest.
According to Simon Arms, all of the areas that the military had occupied became a new playground for the Western artists and became a new world for the Eastern artists who joined them.
Overall, I feel like the use of propaganda has formed the way society is today. Through the use of social media, especially in the most recent election, candidates use strong rhetoric and social media to relate and reach out to the millennials, the least active political generation. The use of media also brought out hidden artists who created new ways of laughter through film. These artists were especially evident during the political campaign, with the use of political commentary to bring out some happiness in a very difficult time. Overall, this trip has made me realize that people have a huge role in how the community functions and prospers. Through the media, people who normally cannot be heard now can be heard by millions of people within a matter of seconds by expressing their frustrations and angers to others who feel the same way, and with enough support can change the dynamic of a community for the greater good.
Overall, going to these countries and learning about their history has helped me grow as a person, not only culturally, but it has also broadened my intelligence, experience, and maturity. Now I am able to reflect on my experiences and relate them back to what I've learned in a deeper and more meaningful way. Living in the age of such high technological advances and freedom, you don't really take the time to think about the life of people during the Holocaust, communism, and war. This has made me realize that I've taken my life for granted by how we are able to express radical ideas through many forms of media and not be ridiculed or punished for it.
The growth of the internet has transformed propaganda beyond anything with its production and spread in the early generations could have imagined. The internet is a wilderness of information that is unlike previous methods of distributing propaganda, near impossible to regulate and manage. Additionally, with the level that we engage with this medium, use it to share, and spread and promote information, we have all become propagandists in the 21st century. Today, the media, especially social media, has taken over how we get our information and angle that we wish to treat the situation. This is very similar to the way that the government during World War I, II, and the communist era controlled the people into believing in a cause. They found an angle that hits emotionally to the people and then sparks and fuels the movement.
This trip has taught me so much about how history, politics, and technology shape design and continue to do so. I now understand how even the smallest event can influence another in a different place and time. Additionally, the trip has really opened my eyes to how war and destruction create resilience within a society that is expressed in all sorts of ways. In all of our excursions, I have seen and heard the stories of people across time. I have realized how art and design allow us to leave behind a voice that never quite goes away. It affects how people perceive the world and provides context for generations to come.
Please step back, it's my style, you're cramping. You here for long, oh no, I'm just passing. Do you wanna drink? Nah, thanks for asking. Ooh, nah, nah, yeah. Don't act like you know me, like you know me. Nah, nah, yeah. I am not your homie, not your homie. Ooh, nah, nah, yeah. Don't act like you know me, like you know me. Nah, nah, yeah. You don't know me.